I'll just get a pair of
airfoils. At least George Knox's appetite remains unimpaired. Field gunners, particularly at feeding times, live segregated lives. For 40 men, there are 4 chefs and sufficient calories to have sunk the Bismarck. And so, as February turns into May and May blossoms into summer, the running times are pared down by remorseless practice from over 4 minutes to under 3. Saturday in June, it's Old Boys Day. Ex-field gunners and old flames arrive in force. However, any resemblance to similar nostalgic gatherings at Eton is somewhat tenuous.
Oh, Daphne!
Daphne's all the
ground. Oh, Daphne!
Back on the reality of the track, the euphoria has gone. It's 3 weeks to Earls Court, and they're suffering from a condition all sports coaches dread. Exhaustion, descent, running times that are actually getting worse. The two trainers are close friends, but in their methods they're as far apart as Freud and Brian Clough. Derek Cousins.
Was it? Gone through that time, what happened?
Gone through?
Well, can I just query something before we start arguing? When you put that new gun to carriage on, yeah, right, did you break it in and stretch it?
But it fitted all right.
Well, I know it fits all right, but did you break it in? And what I mean by breaking in is the tape that's around the side, all right, smashing it with a breech lever, all right, and stretching it with a muzz. Right, well, that's where it all went wrong, because you never broke it in. All right, when you break a gun up rope in, you've got to mould it onto that hook, all right, and you've got to force it, all right, into those little T-joints that are on that bar that carriage sling's gone. All right, remember the last one? We got to break it in. All right, I'll take the blame for that. But captain of the gun, all right, it's his responsibility. All right, it's your gear, Paddy, and it should have been broken in. That's what that part of. Remember the last time we tried to do it here and we had to...
On the far track, where Peter Scott's weapons are the bunched fist and the keel-hauling tongue, the B crew are also floundering in the doldrums.
I can't wait any longer, Kellogg's, other than going back to the second week on the track of waiting to you, for you to put your hand up. What? Explain to me why it come out then. It seemed to come out. There's no explanation at all, is it? No good to me. Box jammed on the run home, why? Don't hold it too high again. Otherwise, I'll hammer you down to a bit shorter status than you are now, all right? We'll go with A, with the gear laid in, until you can put something decent together.
Shit. One person ruin it every time.
Our first trainer at the moment is a fantastic fella. He's all heart, but he hasn't got the sort of aggression that you would expect from a bloke who gets a right sad on, all right? He's has a tendency to not flash up, as I call it, because I flipping, we start doing a wash up, all right, and he'll talk to a person in a sort of soothing action. So a bloke can come away from a wash up just laughing his bleeding head off because he's done something wrong. I think that's completely and utterly wrong. If you do something wrong, even at the actions, I've seen trainers that come along and they'll bash you right around the bleeding head for doing it wrong. And that's the way that you keep them bloody thinking, you put them under stress. Because if they can't run under stress, then it's a waste of time of running. you see, because you're lifting, what, 3/4 of a sodding ton. You can't piss about with 3/4 of a sodding ton.
They doubt each other's capabilities, really. They blame the gear, they blame their opposite numbers. Any excuse, really, and basically it's their fault.
Bugle sounds the final call to regroup, fight, and get it right. On the eve of their departure for London, this was the result.
Analysis of the near-perfect field gun run is what you can't hope to see in the blur of intense competition at Earls Court. After their near despair of a fortnight earlier, it put Portsmouth in excellent spirits for their advance on the Royal Tournament. In fact, it left them with only one minor problem, a field gun officer whose immense skills as a sailor were not quite matched by his performance on a parade ground.
Boss, we can't hear your orders. None of the boys can hear it, I can't hear it, and I'm just the other side of the crew. We're going to have to sort it out. I will pick it up after your Portsmouth.
Okay, yeah.
So you, after Portsmouth, are just talking to yourself.
Okay,
so you just carry on talking to yourself and do your saluting.
Yeah.
Don't forget to salute as well.
Good thinking.
On the eyes right.
Yeah.
I will take it up from there and tell the crew. So I'll just walk alongside you this time, and as you march, give the orders as you would, I will shout over the top of you as I will be off to your right. So I'll stay in behind you.
John. Yeah, the pace is behind me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right,
we give that a throttle.
Right.
I'll step off smartly.
Right, stop there then. We'll just walk around there.
Okay.
Right. I'll give a quick march.
Yeah. Quick. Ow! Portsmouth!
Field gun!
Ice!